My hope is Jesus and nothing else.
There are some people you could only be knowing Muslims. But I want to assure you there are many people who are not Muslims who do not believe in the death and the resurrection of Jesus. Have you ever heard of the so-called intelligent people who calls themselves the New Age movement? They call themselves the atheist. Have you ever heard of people like that? Let me see the hands of those who have ever heard of the atheist.
These atheists
thinks that they are intelligent. The intelligent people. They do not believe in the death and resurrection of Jesus. They still debate that no one can die and rise back to life. Therefore, the biblical stories are just things that were created by people for some time for political plans.
They
wanted to get people and tame people and control them in their own way. But for us, we confirm and we know we are completely assured that Jesus died and rose again. Because the Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, you'll find yourself the verse. The Bible said that if Jesus never died and resurrected, then we are hopeless. If Jesus never died and rose again, those of us who believe, who are believers, who are Christian, we are lost. That's what the Bible says. We are lost. There is no hope. There is no hope of eternal life. There is no hope of life after death. If there is no death and resurrection of Jesus, I want to assure all of you, after you will die, you will go to hell. But because Jesus suffered on the cross and died on the cross and resurrected on the third day, there is hope of resurrection. There is hope of a better life. Praise the Lord. There is hope of life after death. So today, we are celebrating our hope of life after death. Because we know that men were appointed for death. According to Hebrews chapter number 9 verse
27.
All men were appointed for death. And after death, judgment. But Jesus has redeemed us from that judgment. I say Jesus has redeemed us from that judgment. We shall die, yes. But after death, there is eternal life through the blood of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. That's why we celebrate Easter. Unfortunately, there are some believers who believe in Jesus, but they question Easter. Their problem is Easter.
They
say, yes, we believe Jesus died and rose again. But who says that it was this day? Where do you read this? If it was this day, why the days keep changing? For me, I don't care about the changing of days. One thing I know, a Savior died for me. I will celebrate any day. Praise the Lord. I will celebrate his resurrection at any day. Because I know the meaning of his death and resurrection. Praise the Lord. The meaning of his death and his resurrection. The Bible says in John chapter number 3, let's read a verse. John chapter number 3, we find a conversation between Jesus and a man called
Nicodemus.
An intelligent man. A reader of the Jews. And from the Pharisees.
Kandi akomokomba Farisai.
There was a serious conversation here.
Hakabaho ekiganiro kyamanaha.
Remember when Jesus came, he found serious resistance from the Pharisees.
Ijuka Yesu okwizira kashango kwanyisirizwa kwa manu kuruga mba Farisai.
And also from the sect of the Sadducees.
Na no kuruga mba Sadukayo.
And the scribes.
Hamwe na nabahandichi.
There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God. This was wonderful because the Pharisees never believed that Jesus was coming from God. And they were fighting that seriously. And actually, this is one of the reasons why they decided to crucify Jesus. But one of them, Nicodemus by name, comes in the night. The reason why he comes in the night, he knows it's dangerous for him to go when it's day. Because his fellows will pick on him. So he comes at night separately. He come to Jesus. And this time he calls him teacher. Because they had refused to call him a teacher. Because they saw him as man who was misreading people. He's accepting everybody. And according to the law, not everybody should be accepted.
You
people should thank Jesus.
I
say we should thank Jesus. According to the law, not everyone was to be accepted. So this man sits with the tax collectors. He eats with harlots. So the Pharisee said he can never be a teacher from God. He can't be a teacher from God and then he sits with the tax collectors and sinners. But this one, Nicodemus said, Rabbi, some of us know that you are a teacher from God. For none can do these signs that you do unless is with God. Now let me read quickly. Verse number 3. Jesus answered and said to him, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot even see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, how can a man be born again when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of water and of the Spirit, he can never enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it is come from and where it goes. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said to him, how can these things be? How can these things be? Verse number 10. Jesus answered and said to him, are you a teacher of Israel and do not know these things? Most assuredly, I said to you, we speak what we know and testify what we have seen, and you do not receive our witness. If I have told you If I've told you the earthly things and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you the heavenly things? No one has ascended from heaven, but he who came down from heaven, that is the Son of the Man, of the Son of Man, which is in heaven. And verse 14 says, and as Moses, this one is very important. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have it everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. He who believes in him is not condemned, but he who does not believe in him is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
Ebigambo byemulidde bigambo bitukuvu.
As you've heard, a holy.
Afazal, I get your attention. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's the reason why it was designed, you know, after they have read this. Ebigambo byemulidde bigambo bitukuvu. So that your attention will come back. Let's clap for them. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the words that you have heard are holy words of God. And very important for your soul.
Nibikuru munonga habwa magara gawe.
Nicodemus represents you.
Nicodemus nazwecheriwe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nicodemus stands Nicodemu in your place.
Ati anayemi romu nganya
kwa hati. Thank God for Nicodemus.
Si marhangawa Nicodemus.
That he went and asked those questions.
Wakajenda ya buze.
So that Jesus can answer those questions.
Demuyesa haka rikame buze.
That you and me will know.
Iwe na anye tumanye.
What is the truth?
The
Bible said about a man here, Nicodemus, from the Pharisee.
I've
already told you that these people never believed in Jesus. They conflicted with Jesus because they thought he has come to take away their work. Because they were the teachers about God. They were the religious leader of those days. And they had a doctrine to teach. They had a doctrine to defend. And this man comes with a new doctrine, which shows that their work is going to be affected. So they resisted him. They fought him. But finally, one of them came in the night. He calls him Rabbi. Rabbi means the teacher. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I believe Jesus was surprised to see a Pharisee this time saying you are a teacher. And Jesus straight away go to the serious matter. Brethren, there is a serious matter. Tell your neighbor there is a serious matter. And I think the church, we are in a time when we need to talk about the serious matter. The serious matter. Many times the church goes on minor matters. We so much major on the minor. And you find us conflicting on minors. I think time has come for preachers to go to the serious matter. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus straight away went on the serious matter. Maybe Nicodemus expected him to begin debating about who should be the right teacher. No, Jesus does not want to know who is the right teacher or whatever. Maybe he expected to hear Jesus debating about the the doctrines, whatever. No, Jesus was not ready for that. Maybe Nicodemus expected to hear Jesus asking to debate about who is right, who is wrong. But Jesus goes straight to the serious matter. I said the serious matter will not mind the Easter has come on which date. Did you hear me? The serious matter will not consider on which date Easter has come. Sometimes we go into minor things and we exalt them above the major things. I've told you there's some believers, even some pastors who debate on this Easter, who tell us which was the real day he resurrected. I don't need to know that. One thing I know, Jesus resurrected for our future life. Jesus died on the cross. He hanged on the cross because of our sins. Because we were alienated, we were separated from the kingdom of God. We were strangers. We were heathens. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And Jesus went on the cross to remove the separation. That even the Jews can receive forgiveness, can receive the promises of God, can be included in the covenant of the promises. So I don't care which date, when he was hanged. One thing I know, he hanged on the cross for my sins. That is the serious matter. And after that, I need to question, to ask myself, have I received from what this man suffered for? Do I understand it? Do I take it serious? Oh, I just talk about it and come on that day and buy a new suit, a new shoe, and go to church, and then after there I go and eat as if I've not been eating.
Brethren, every day we eat. And every time
na yoro nakulono ruli na kensonge nkuru.
This day has
been kusabira gwe yaze wano.
Which I'm praying for you. You understand that issue.
Jesus asked the believers, yes. He asked the Jews.
Yes, you have observed that.
He said, why did you go to the wilderness to see? What did you go to see? Did you go to see a reed that is being moved by the wind? Why did you go there? In Matthew chapter 11, he was questioning them. Praise the Lord. Why did you go to the wilderness to do? Did you go to see a prophet? Yes, he's a prophet. What did you go to the wilderness to see, to do? Did you go to see someone who is putting on the white robes or the glorious clothes? He told them those who put on well, they are found in the king's palaces. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he told them, actually, John is greater than anyone among those who are born of women. No one is greater than John. But the least in the kingdom of God is talking about you. The least of you who is in the kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. And then he tells them, therefore I tell you, from the days of John the Baptist up to now, the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. It suffers violence because when you move from this group of the intelligent men and you begin to believe in this so seen as nonsense, you need to be violent. A man with masters. A man with PhD. To move from the so-called intelligent group. And you come to Holy Ghost Fire Church. And you begin to sing Yazu. Kira.
From the dead.
And they look at you. You need to be violent. A man who has a beautiful car. A man who has built a wonderful house. A man who is traveling nations. A man who is great in the nation. To move and come here. You need to be violent. A woman who is coming from a well-known family.
The person who is understanding.
You
go into those foolish
things. Need to be violent. I say you need to be violent. You need to be violent. Up to now, there are people who go into the wilderness. You know, this Easter can also be termed as the wilderness. He was talking about the people who had gone to the wilderness to be baptized by John the Baptist. Because they poured there. As if they were serious. And afterwards, they killed John.
Baita Yohana.
He says, why did you go there? You just went there to see a reed being moved by the wind. Why did you waste your time to go to the church because of Easter or Christmas? Did you go to see people who are putting on big robes? He says, actually, those ones are found in the king's palaces. Did you go there to see a prophet? Actually, he is a prophet. And among those who are born of women, no one is greater than John the Baptist. But I want to tell you the list. The list of those who have believed the kingdom. The list among those who have known the purpose. The list of those who are serious with the words of the kingdom is greater than John the Baptist. And from the days of John the Baptist up to now, the kingdom of God suffers violence. I pray for in the name of Jesus.
Gentlemen, I pray
Katonda
for you. May the Lord help you.
And
you put something in you
that will take you above whatever you are. Whatever you own, whatever name you own, you need that grace of God that will cause you to forget the beautiful car you have. That will cause you to forget that excellent degree.
It says all these
are
the
sacrifice. But Jesus shed his blood. My blood might be spared.
Give him the first blessing.
The Bible says in Romans, chapter number 6, that when one dies, there's a quick room sin. Let me read those verses quickly as they bring the Holy Communion. Today we are going to celebrate the death of Jesus Christ. We are going to take Holy Communion. Holy Communion was meant to bring our heart meet together with the heart of Jesus. Holy Communion was meant to change your weak body into the stronger body of Jesus Christ. Your body, which has been vulnerable to diseases, as you take the Holy Communion, your heart with your mind, your body is going to be strengthened. Taken Holy Communion and got healed of cancer.
We need
to take it with understanding. Now, chapter 6 of Romans, verse 7. For he whom has died has been freed from sin. Now, if we die with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. Knowing that Christ, having been raised from the dead, dies no more. Jesus, after dying and resurrecting from the dead, he dies no more. Death no longer has dominion over him. Verse number 10. For the death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. That's really very important for you. Likewise, you also reform yourself to be dead indeed, you see, but alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We reform ourselves dead to see.
We are ready
to live. To meet the world of
Christ.
And if the world, I want to
prosper.
That means there is no connection. May the Lord help every one of us.
So then I say, I will
and we live like that.
To let you.
So that nothing will happen in
the world.
This one does not mean we shall remain poor. We are going to become rich.
But
we shall not allow riches to sit on us. We shall live to Jesus. This one does not mean we should not study. Study and become a professor.
But
education will not be lifted above ourselves.
Amen.
If you do that, you shall have 100 here, and after here,
eternal
life. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord prosper you. Because he died for you, and he promised that he's going to prepare a place for you, and he will come back for you, take you where he is, that you may be with him.
My hope is Jesus and nothing else. Oh, such love and grace leads me to see my Savior's face.